Someone I know just said that his ideal girl would be 6'4" and 80 to 90 pounds. So your ideal girl is going to cave in and die. What? What's 80 pounds in kilograms? 36 kilograms! Oh my God, you're out of your mind. I'd easily almost be like 3 times that. Like, what is that? Maybe he just got confused or... I don't know what happened here. Like that Simpsons episode where Lisa's trying to buy clothes and those girls are like, oh my God, I heard that she's back to her birth weight.
I heard she's back to her birth weight.
Icky, icky, gross, gross, yuck. We're already doing more bad women's anatomy. I truly can't stay away from this subreddit. Welcome back, everybody. Hope you're doing fantastic. Thank you for being here. Thank you for tuning back in. I hope you're excited to read a whole bunch of nonsense. I'm having a really good day. Well, I did have a really good day. It's nighttime now. I don't even know what time it is. I hope you guys are doing great, and I hope everything in your life is going amazing. Okay, bad women's anatomy time. Enjoy. Just tell your partner that you're not into a specific kink that they have. Here's the big secret about being in a healthy relationship. If you tell them that you don't want to do something, they'll say, okay, then we won't do that. Yes, same. What if I meet someone and they want to do, you know what? I'd be crushed. It's gross enough that the vajayjay hole has pee out of it and is next to poop. Aww. Oh my God, how old is this person? The you know what hole doesn't have pee out of it. That's a separate hole above it. Yeah, you don't pee out of there. Of course, this is the first post that we read. Another guy that doesn't understand that there's more than one hole. When in doubt, dude, Google it. This is why it's so important to wipe the toilet seat after a woman used it, obviously. There's always a chance that otherwise she dropped some of her eggs onto the rim by accident. Because vajayjays aren't locked up, so that when a guy sits down, those eggs may travel up into his, you know. If the male then has intercourse, those eggs will be fertilized, resulting in a male pregnancy. Simple biology. This is why most men refuse to sit down on toilet seats. That was so good. Surely it's a joke. Come on, there's no way that's not a joke. Yeah, that's why most men refuse to sit on the toilet seat, because otherwise they might get an egg on them. Oh my God. You don't leave your eggs on the toilet seat. That's disgusting. My videos get weirder every day. I think we've read this one before, but it's okay. New Zealand is making period-free products free in all schools. Oh God. All this is going to do is encourage girls to have their periods at school. I don't think this is a good idea. You're joking, right? I can't tell because like everything on Twitter is sarcastic. It's going to encourage girls to have their periods at school. Yeah, okay. You think they're in control of when they have them? Some people actually have no idea. Starts freaking you in the click. Dude, I don't even know you. Also, what's the click, LMAO? Do you mean the, you know? Don't be disrespectful to daddy or he won't let you, you know what? I literally have never spoken to you in my life. Pushing down harder on the, yeah. Yeah, baby girl, but you like it like this. There's no way that this guy actually thinks that he's like being sexy is there. That's hilarious. Trying to be all cute and sexy with the role playing, which already is not cute and sexy, even if you do it right. But as we read, it's not right. I don't know if it makes it better or worse. Like, is this funny or sad? I can't tell. A grown man gets mad that I choose to lose my... Can I say that? I don't know. To my best friend instead of a boyfriend. Why are you doing this with a friend? How about a potential husband? Why are you concerned with who I do it with? Because life outcomes for women are inversely correlated with their number of... partners. Their ability to pair bond declines. Their market value for marriage declines. Google it. I have 4 daughters. I know a lot about this topic. Oh, that's so gross. And when one of these sorts of guys tells you to Google it, and talking about this woman's market value for marriage, what does that even mean? It just seems so gross. Like, I barely even know what they're talking about, and I know it's wrong. I really hope they're lying about the 4 daughters. Can't even imagine what sort of stuff he'd be be telling them. Okay, that went from funny to sad really fast. Yeast infection cure. Oh, great. I can't find the garlic up there. Did it fall out? Is it okay if it stays up there? I read that you're supposed to take it out after one night. My fingers are short. I can't even reach my, you know what? Which my, you know what, is way up and to the left because of my genetic disorder. But I feel a weird pinching sensation high up in there. Is it the damn garlic? How am I gonna get it out? I have 3 weeks until my due date. I'm freaking out now. Wait, so you're pregnant and to cure a yeast infection, you put garlic up there? What, like a clove of garlic or something? Oh, and like the fact that it's garlic just makes me think of food and that makes me want to cry. I catcall people's dogs and they think I'm catcalling them when I say something like, so fine or damn, when they walk by with their dog and then I hit them with, your dog is just so adorable, beautiful, awesome, and watch their reaction. That is so lame, dude. That's only funny if you're like 11 years old. Please do not do this to women who are alone. We get enough harassment already. This isn't that funny. Your tampon too big. What? Maybe they are 11. I'd like to think that grown adults wouldn't find this sort of stuff funny, but I know a lot of guys would. It's like those old Instagram videos where they walk up to women and they're like, oh my god, I love your melons. And then they put like a guy behind her with like 2 melons. Like, ah, hilarious. Oh, morning boner freaking stinks. Makes my hand smell. Have you tried washing it? No, no, no. Washing it would be a feminine trait. I'm very certain that that's a joke. And I'm so glad it is. I'm not even going to consider that that isn't a joke. It has to be. I just learned today from TikTok that girls like funny guys because when they laugh, it shakes their, you know what, releasing hormones that make the guy more attractive. Like he's shaking bloody chicken salt or something. What are you talking about? Every time you shake it, hormones come out. This subreddit is so stupid. I love it. Same thing as you don't want used shoes, or at least I don't want shoes that have been used by 50 people before. People aren't objects. Did I claim them to be? I have my preferences and qualities that I want from my wife. You literally compared women to shoes. Yeah, it's a metaphor. I don't want a woman who's been with multiple men. Thank God my girlfriend hasn't. This thing is so simple to understand, but for some reason you keep coping. I value women who don't share themselves with half of the city. Problem. I want to laugh. I want to cry. I'm frustrated. These guys really bring out my emotions. I never rent to single mothers, or all women for that matter, because I don't want you-know-what blood sprayed all over my units. No. I don't even have a response for this one. Like what? How am I meant to react to that? Dude, are you okay? And like, even if they're joking, it's not funny. That's bloody terrifying. Why do men think that you-know-whats get loose if you sleep with 30 different people, but it stays tight if you sleep with the same person 30 times? The guys that we read about on these sorts of subreddits, they don't think. That's what the issue is. I don't think they've ever thought about anything before they've said it. Why do women sometimes pee like a fountain and other times like a waterfall? It has a lot to do with how big their you-know-what is. The bigger the vajayjay, the heavier the flow. It's basic physics. No, it's not. Is that the same for guys then, man? No, it's not. I love how we learn on this channel. We're learning every single day from these crazy people. Did you know that if a man does it unprotected with 2 females in one day, the male can carry an egg from one female to another, resulting in her having a baby that's not even hers? And this is the point in the video where we look at wholesome memes. I'm not even commenting on this one. I'm done. When the light's green and the car in front of you is sitting there, but you're in a good mood, it's okay, Rocky. You go when you feel like it. And then the other times, get out of the way. I've got places to be, man. No, very nice, very wholesome. The person I'm today would like to thank the person I was 5 years ago for not giving up. Yeah, that's so true. Good on everybody out there that just doesn't give up. Whether it's like your health or your fitness, or whether it's like what I'm doing with YouTube, like I'm so glad that I never never gave up. Well done, guys. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching today's video. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you like, make sure you subscribe, and leave a comment down below what you thought. I love hearing from you guys. Today's comment of the day goes to a username that I can't even attempt to pronounce from my last Nice Guys video. If he feels the need to say, "I swear I'm a nice guy," then you can bet that he's not a nice guy. Yeah, that's exactly right. Whether it's the Nice Guys or it's the I'm very smart or the I'm very badass, as soon as you have to try and convince everybody else that you're a certain way, like, one, you wouldn't care about convincing people and you wouldn't need to convince people. You would just be that sort of person. But yeah, I don't think Nice Guys will ever understand. All right, everybody, hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. Have a wonderful night, and I'll see you tomorrow at the exact same time with at least one, maybe two new videos. I'll see you then.